history, some history. This is a, because he can he can't write something, town or house, etc. I just make original letter from him.
It's
not a bit
of
not
deficiency as well, I feel like.
He's
some
toxic. Some toxic. Yeah. From traditional Chinese medicine, it's true. It's true. Blood heat, blood toxin.
And wind.
A wind, yes, of course, could be wind. It's itching, it's moving from traditional, yes, it's true. Yeah.
Too much weight in the heat.
Too much.
Too much weight in the heat.
Dumping.
Yes, sure.
Okay. So they don't have tongue picture. I did not put it here. Yes. His tongue, let me see. Looks quite. Looks quite normal. To be honest, it's something light red, with slightly bigger. Not smaller, slightly bigger, but without a teeth mark.
So that means the heat, if it's
of course, they are rare, itching, from typical TCM, it is, because we said heat,
not
heat or something like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
But from tongue, no, not like that. Okay.
No heat and no deficiency.
But
the tongue, in the tongue, there's no deficiency.
From the tongue, why I'm saying is slight deficiency
of
something like a spleen.
Yeah, yeah.
But slightly, not obviously thick, thick tongue coating, big tongue, teeth mark. That's typical spleen. But it's slightly, bigger. Yeah.
Oh, he
suffered
from asthma or hay fever or something like that. Allergic history. Sometimes if people
with
asthma,
they
kind of
For this case, he mentioned from his childhood asthma.
Childhood
eczema. Eczema.
Did there something happen when you were 6 years old? No, 6 months. Was there something happened when he was 6 months old?
No. No specific history.
No.
Yeah. Just noticed. Yeah. Then slightly better. In some years, when in summer 2012, getting worse. So until he came to see me, October 2015, about three years, he suffered a severe eczema. Tried many things. Yeah.
This is atopic eczema.
Yeah, atopic eczema.
And normally it doesn't stay always like this. Normally stay until the age of 8 and 9, then it laps.
Yes.
And then the remission again after, I think, 25 years.
Possibly, yeah. Yes, I said, typically, yes. Yes, most of the area, hands, fingers, left. Okay. Treatment, my treatment. Yeah, because some typical TCM, we are using this sector, but unfortunately, not good for him. Yeah. Not my treatment, let me see. Early stage, the first month, acupuncture plus herbs, twice per week. Acupuncture, two groups. Okay, you can see my points. 220, 224, in tongue, part 7, part 4, you see, spleen 10, spleen 9, liver 3. Scalp acupuncture, SA is scalp acupuncture, okay. Sensory area.
There's a movement area and a sensory
area.
Yeah, isn't
there a
common from the...
Yes, this is a movement area, then sensitive area.
Yeah,
sensitive areas. The group 2, do 16, do 14, let's see. Do 11, do 10, almost all the 2 points. Mm. So what mean group 1, group 2?
Alternative.
Yes, alternatively. Because twice a week. Once on the front, once on the back. Yes, then because it was so sick, I prepared some herbs as well. They say, Shen Di, Zhi Mu, Huang Bai, they are all typically TCM herbs.
Did you needle a bladder 40 Wei Zhong or did you bleed it? Is it just when you did the Wei Zhong on bladder 40?
Yeah, we have it. No, I did not use bladder.
Just needle.
Just needle.
Okay.
Just needle. And not use bleeding. Yeah. I understand your meaning, yes. Occasionally by accident,
right,
in some
right, right.
But not,
not purposeful.
Yeah, no,
okay.
Yes.
But you say according to his tongue, you said there is a minor or a small speechy deficiency.
Minor speech.
Well, okay.
Minor, yes.
So why have you decided to go to the Dumai?
Yes. Very good question. Very good question. Yeah, what do you understand? Why for this pain I think about the Dumai?
So what is your diagnostic?
Because you think there's something in the blood.
Heat in the blood, yes.
Do 20, do 24, yin tang, heart 7, all for the heart and the shen.
Yes.
Because heat in the blood will disturb the shen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Is that why you...
It's one point. It's one explanation from you.
Okay.
So the question, as Saki mentioned, why I think about the key points are one to my points. As I mentioned here today, to my points. I believe this is not a commonly prescription of points on treating skin conditions or eczema.
No.
I think a couple of months ago I delivered a workshop in Amsterdam for the brain theory and the practice on skin conditions. This is one case I used as well.
Why use the Dumai in this occasion? This patient is suffering the skin, but why we use the points of the Dumai?
Yes. Because
a lot of stress, I think.
And stress.
Yeah, this is one point or one symptom indicated about the Dumai. But normally, if we imagine something with stress, skin problem plus stress, normally we choose a heart 7 or something a little bit under 20 or some other heart points. Normally, or liver 3, something like that.
Yes.
Yeah, but that's most commonly practiced.
So, it may be that because these conditions are all over the body.
Yes.
So, you can't put the liver all over the body. The Dumai is the control, the governor control vessel.
Mm-hmm.
They can rebalance all the,
mm-hmm.
like if you say for the spleen or kidney,
mm-hmm.
heater or rebalance the immune system, that you know, that the skin can break.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are several reasons or signal to let me think about if I use just normal hours, as in heart blood or wind or spleen qi deficiency or even normally liver qi stagnation, etc. I don't think it makes sense for him, because he has tried many of treatment, and his cream, lots of cream as well, not so good. Cream only make the moisture slightly better, not scratching, particularly during the, because it's disturbed his sleep. You can imagine, he mentioned it's the very, we say, the itching during
itching.
Sleep. Normally the itching mostly getting worse during sleep. Both skin conditions.
Yeah, all of the itchings of the skin is a source of the trouble from the heart. That's the medicine, you say.
Okay. Yeah. So,
这些皆属于心,
3 years suffering from this condition, you can imagine. Lots of stress.
Yes.
Lots of stress. Anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
And general. Whole body, not just one area or one channel, it's a general. Both hands, both leg, chest, back, etc. So all this, the history, the symptom, the conditions, area, actually indicate in the later stage or long, many years suffering, brain shen involved.
Mm-hmm. Which
Ren Shen. Or you can say Ren Shen involved already.
Mm.
You got some photo for his skin after treatment?
Of course. I'm sure now. The next stage, after a month, I use acupuncture only, the herbs. You know, even at the first month, the patient at the beginning, they don't want to take the herbs. Because he tried lots of herbs previously with other practitioners. Not good. Even make him uncomfortable, like digesting, etc. But because it's so severe, I suggest, okay, the first month, you try some herbs. I use a very, very minor dose of herbs. It's herb powder. Less than half of normal dose. Most of them just 2 to 3 or 3 to 4 grams. Very tiny dose. Yeah. The next stage, only acupuncture. Most of them still do math, but slightly change. You can see, a later stage, I use scalp acupuncture emotion. You can't find a scalp acupuncture emotion where. This is a new developer on scalp acupuncture.
That's what I was going to ask. Where is that?
Yes, yes. Yeah. During the break, because I don't know if I mentioned that. Next weekend, I gave a scalp acupuncture workshop, 2 days in south of London. With 2 days, the one my friend possibly wants to join this workshop. I'm asked, is this exact the same as the Professor Zhao Sun Fa's scalp acupuncture, Chinese acupuncture, scalp acupuncture I mentioned? Yes. The basic principles is what we call the Chinese scalp acupuncture, with 15 areas. But in the last 40 days after publish of scalp acupuncture, there are also some areas developing. One of the developing areas is emotional area. Yeah. Briefly speaking, emotional area is, we have 4 lines around this area.
Yeah.
Motor area, sensitive area, the coma area, and the vessel area. Mm. Emotional area is 2 centimeters away from the middle line and 2 centimeters, then along with line, 4 centimeters now. Just something around here.
Okay.
Emotional area. And sorry for the time, I can't get more detail. Yeah. And also you can see I use some of the Jing points. Yeah, I guess not so much Jing points here. Jing points, yeah. And of course, the second group, I take off blood 40, plus 2 lines and 3. So this is, of course, not every time exact same, slightly different. Because I've treated this guy about a year now. From twice a week to once a week, to once every 2 weeks, to once every month. Nowadays, about every 2 or 3 or 4 months, 4 weeks, once. Show you the picture. About 2 months ago, yes, I made some picture. And I also suggested him do some self-dao-qi. Dao-qi technique is a real needling, but self-dao-qi is partly similar to our qigong.
Mm.
Also dao-qi. Mm. I tell him how some practice of qi movement, etc., etc. Yeah.
And then
all
2 points, are you going deeply?
2 points. Not all of them. Not all of them. And depends on different stage.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Then, okay, current stage, which was 2 months ago, I take this picture. Oh, this first, the word he write to me, give me feedback. The skin generally improving and almost gone. Clear from hands and arm. His words. Still have some itching behind the knee and on shins, but these are slowly improving. I'm not dependent on using creams multiple times per day. He used to take this one. I often forget to apply any cream in the morning or before bed. He even quite often forgot it. He's suffering from this itching. I'm much more relaxed about my skin. Which means it was anxiety and stressed, always thinking about his skin. This is the current stage by his words. Picture?
Serious difference.
Yeah.
And you've been treating him for about a year.
Yes, about a year.
Okay.
So occasionally, slightly, you can see. The same, yes. Occasionally, some slight blister, something around here, or here, you see.
Mm.
Slightly, he mentioned it.
Okay, slightly.
But he always forget it. Yeah. Then, next picture. This was the first picture I take about the, I think the first